Live in amazing times, folks. Absolutely amazing times. If I could choose any time in history to live, quite honestly, any time in history to live, I would clearly pick right now. I hope you would too. 570 WNEX is the Drive Time Show.
Listen for Minnesota Vikings football on 570 WNAX.
Thursday's market closings in WNEX saw cattle and hogs lower and the grains mixed on the Merc. December live cattle 108.25 down 240. The February down 262 at 110.52. And April down 242 at 114.20. November feeder cattle down 25, 136.77. January 135.55 down 175. And March feeder cattle down 195 at 134.95. Box beef, the choice up 186, selects up 27, choice select spread 23.81, and total loads at 152. Estimated livestock slaughter 119,000 cattle, 491,000 hogs, and 7,000 sheep. December lean hogs down 210 at 63.70. February 63.05 down 285. And April down 255 at 66.22. Western Corn Belt direct hogs up 168 at 58.88. Iowa, Minnesota direct hogs up 44 at 58.97. Board of Trade, December corn down 3 1/4, 422 1/2. March, 427 1/4, down 3 1/4. December 21, corn 407 3/4, down 1 1/4. January soybeans 1177 1/2, up 1 3/4. March up 3/4, 1175 1/2. And November 21, soybeans down 1/2 at 1051. January soybean meal 392.30 a ton, down $1.50. January soybean oil up 30 at 38.51. December Chicago wheat 591 3/4, down 6. December Kansas City wheat 548 3/4, down 9. December Minneapolis wheat down 4, 546 1/4. December oats down 1/4, 297 1/4. On your cash grains, Hans and Mueller, Sioux City corn 402, soybeans 1127, Cargill Sioux City soybeans 1138, CVA Akron corn 397, soybeans 1112, Farmers Co-op Society Sioux Center corn 415, soybeans 1113, Marcus corn 419, CHS Mankato soybeans 1143, ADM corn Marshall $4, Columbus corn 415, Minnesota soybean processors 1122, Poet and Hudson corn 406, Napa Junction corn 391, soybeans 1122, New Gen Marion corn 402, Actegra Craven spring wheat 491, winter wheat 524, Actegra Huron spring wheat 506, winter wheat 529, Northside Laurel corn 393, soybeans 1113, Siouxland ethanol corn 396, Husker Ag LLC corn 398. Those are markets in WNEX.
Now the O'Reilly update brings you something you might not know. 157 years ago today, President Abraham Lincoln delivered a short address on a quiet field in Pennsylvania. On that spot, 4 months earlier, 50,000 Americans were either killed or wounded in a battle that was as ferocious as anything ever seen on the planet. President Lincoln's words will be remembered as one of the great speeches in human history, the Gettysburg Address. After that brutal battle in 1863, the president was invited to consecrate a cemetery at the site, many believe was the turning point of the entire Civil War. The speech was just 270 words long, beginning with the iconic phrase, 47 years ago. Surrounded by Union soldiers and members of his cabinet, Abe Lincoln delivered the address in less than 3 minutes. Few in attendance could actually hear what Abe was saying. Copies of his speech were published in newspapers around the country. The Philadelphia Inquirer ran the entire copy of the speech on its front page. Now, the address is regarded, along with Shakespeare, as the finest prose in the English language. At the 75th anniversary of the battle, Franklin Roosevelt said, quote, "Immortal deeds and immortal words have created here at Gettysburg a shrine of American patriotism, words in which Abraham Lincoln expressed the simple faith for which they died," unquote. Martin Luther King Jr. referenced Lincoln's words in the opening line of his I Have a Dream speech, stating, quote, 50 years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation, unquote. And here's something else you might not know. I, your humble correspondent, have seen the actual written Gettysburg Address. It is in the Lincoln bedroom at the White House. President Obama was kind enough to personally show it to me after I interviewed him. Back after this. Investors, are you seeking steady cash flow, ready to diversify? Have you considered a proven real estate investment fund? NRIA is one of the nation's leading realty specialists and offers 10% annualized monthly payouts with bonuses targeted to 21%. That's right, you could receive steady 10% return monthly payments with bonuses. You know, they specialize in realty investing done right. Even use your 401k or IRA to invest. NRIA's 15-year track record and $1.2 billion in new construction development backs you. So learn how you can invest in this hard asset real estate cash flow fund today and receive 10% annualized monthly payouts with bonuses. This is something savvy investors should research and consider. Please call now, 201-210-2727. 201-210-2727 or visit NRIA.net.
An offer to buy or sell any security is only made by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. National is a real estate development firm. See us at NRIA.net.
Thank you for listening to the O'Reilly Update. I am Bill O'Reilly. No spin, just facts, and always looking out for you.
Your local FS is member-owned, and that means when you buy our flagship brands like FS Envision and FS HiSoy, you're actually buying seed from yourself. And you wouldn't sell yourself anything but the best, would you? In field after field, FS brands are out-yielding the competition. Talk to your local FS crop specialist about Envision corn or HiSoy soybean seed today. At harvest, you'll be glad you did. Envision and HiSoy are available exclusively at your local FS member company.
Waiting for the best time to get a new truck or SUV? That time is now. Hurry into your local Northland Ford dealer or visit buyfordnow.com where you'll save big on the full lineup of 2020 Ford models. Like the completely redesigned Escape and Explorer, the powerful Edge, the roomy Ford Expedition, or America's best-selling truck, Ford F-150. Buy now to get the absolute best deal on Ford's full lineup of cars, trucks, and SUVs, including all the technology and safety features to keep you in command and in control. From the driveway to the highway. Buy now and earn low financing on your next great Ford. Go anywhere, do anything, and bring everyone. There's no time like now, because these great deals won't be around forever. Don't wait. Get to your local Northland Ford dealer or visit buyfordnow.com today. Best-selling truck claim based on 2019 CY sales.
Check out the huge Jim and Rose deal, timed online farm retirement auction in Bonesteel, South Dakota. Bidding opens at 8 a.m. on Monday, November 23rd, and closes Tuesday, December 1st at 10:30 a.m. You'll find a huge selection of farm and livestock equipment. Go to stephisgroup.com today for a complete list and description of auction equipment for this and other upcoming auctions. Log on to steffesgroup.com right now for more information on the Jim and Rose Steel Farm Retirement Auction in Bonesteel, South Dakota.
Excel Machine and Manufacturing. They provide custom replacement parts for agricultural equipment, like manure spreaders. They specialize in producing high-quality apron chains and paddles that outperform many mainstream replacements. They repair most leading brands of silage trailers, silage boxes, and live bottom belt trailers. Excel's trained and experienced staff will help keep your equipment running. Save money repairing equipment instead of purchasing factory parts. Let Excel move your product. Excel Machine and Manufacturing in Wood, Iowa. Visit them at manurespreaderparts.com.
Give yourself a big hug. Buckle up. Don't ride with Jim Reaper. Brought to you by the South Dakota Office of Highway Safety.
CBS News Brief. California is imposing a curfew across about 90% of the state to stem the rapid rise of coronavirus cases. The 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. stay-at-home order will take effect Saturday and last a month. The state's Health and Human Services Secretary, Dr. Mark Galley.
Even though we have the hope of vaccine and the discussions about what lies ahead on that front, we have to take care of the urgency of the day.
It comes on the same day the CDC advised people not to travel next week for Thanksgiving. Stephanie Sampson is spokeswoman for Los Angeles International Airport.
Last year we saw over 3 million passengers. This year we know about half of those seats have been sold, and we really don't know how many people will actually end up going to their flight.
On the vaccine front, Dr. Anthony Fauci says it's okay that companies developed one quickly.
We need to put to rest any concept that this was rushed in an inappropriate way. This is really solid.
CBS News Brief. I'm Matt Piper.
Yep, I saw that. That was wonderful. That's why I didn't even...
With WNEX News, I'm Tom Ryder. A very different and possibly difficult holiday shopping season is ahead for retailers. The ongoing pandemic is expected to sharply cut into traditional Black Friday sales. Ernie Goss, an economics professor at Creighton University in Omaha, says many businesses will have a hard time finding full and part-time workers.
We've also seen, despite a higher unemployment rate compared to pre-coronavirus levels, businesses that we survey, bank CEOs that we survey, manufacturers that we survey, report finding and hiring qualified workers remains an issue. So even with the higher unemployment rates, finding those workers is still a problem.
Guy says this might be the last holiday season for many retailers.
We are going to see rising bankruptcies, rising foreclosures, and so forth, the economic problems in the first quarter, particularly for smaller retailers, for smaller companies. The nationals are going to be hurt as well, but not nearly as much as the small local retailers.
Goss says people need to take advantage of their local businesses when they can. Goss is predicting an increase of 1 to 3% in holiday spending this year. The 2020 election saw many voters cast their ballot in ways much different than they're used to. The pandemic resulted in a surge in absentee voting by mail. However, drive-through voting also surfaced, and one Iowa official believes it has staying power. Johnson County Auditor Travis Weipert says he was floored when people asked to bring the option back for future elections. Weipert says he thought it was just a one-and-done deal because of the crisis and concerns about voting in person.
I have received so many thank yous and letters of you're going to continue the drive-through voting, right?
Scott County Auditor Roxana Mortz, who also is president of the Iowa State Association of County Auditors, credits Weipert's work to make voting more accessible, but she thinks logistics will make it harder for the option to catch on throughout the state.
Of course, you'd have to have enough staff to be able to do that, and you'd have to have a venue such as what he had to be able to do that.
As for absentee voting, Weipert believes people who tried it for the first time this year will do so again, not only for the convenience, but because it also helps them become more informed voters.
The other thing I hear from voters is it gives me a chance to look up the judges and other candidates I knew nothing about and actually vote on that race.
With WNEX News, I'm Tom Ryan.
We're the voice of the Midwest, 570 WNAX.
Do you want to unlock the secret to higher yields? If you're applying dry fertilizer, the key to better yield potential is Titan XC. Titan XC is a unique biocatalyst that unlocks and releases the bound-up nutrients in granular fertilizer, promoting better root uptake and plant growth. Release more nutrient, expect better results with Titan XC. For more information, visit cropfertility.com. That's cropfertility.com. Or call your Nutrient Ag Solutions crop consultant today. Always read and follow label directions.
Hang 2,500 out of 3, now 3,000 out of 3,500 out of 4, now 4, now 3,500 out of 4, now 4,000 out of 4,500 out of 5, 5,000 out of
4,500 out of 6, now 6,500 out of 6, now 6,500 out of 7, now 7,500 out of 7, now 7,500 out of 7. The first parcel we'd like to tell you about is northeast of Rock Rapids, Iowa, in Riverside Township, Lyon County, Iowa. We'll be selling this in 276-acre parcels of excellent farmland for the Gertrude Infelt Estate. This is some top-quality farm ground. It is in half-mile rows. On December 1, 2020, we'll be north of George, Iowa, in Liberal Township, Lyon County, Iowa, selling two parcels of farmland for the Richard Ackerman family. This farmland has excellent soil types and is also farmed in half-mile rows. If you are looking for some excellent farmland, then be sure to check out one of these great auctions today. Check out ZomerAuctions.com for details on these two great Lyon County,
Sold at $7,000 right there to number 92. $7,000, number 92.
570 WNAX, it is the Drive Time Show. Vaughn and Steve on a Thursday. -51 degrees still at our WNAX studios. Been a gorgeous day for sure. Tomorrow looks like it's going to be pretty nice too yet, Steve.
I think so. Not quite as warm, but not too bad.
If sunshiny, mostly sunny, I should say, in 52. We'll take that. We'll take that on the 20th of November. Now, I had called for between 60 and 70 degrees, somewhere between 60 and 70 degrees on Thanksgiving Day. I was hoping it would be 55.5 so I could round it up to 60 so I would be right.
But?
It looks like a high near 46.
Ooh.
So, I'm trying to figure out here, Steve.
Yeah?
If it would hit 50, 49.5 actually, I could round that up to 100 and then just average it. Right?
I see.
Wow. I mean, I'm just trying to use the numbers game to make things work.
Do you do your own taxes, too?
I'm not at liberty to discuss my tax situation because we know the FBI and the NSA listen. It's a possibility that the IRS does, too.
Yeah.
They don't seem all that concerned about the $3.50 an hour I make. Yeah, they seem concerned about the 25 cents an hour that I fail to give them sometimes. That's what it seems like the issue is.
Hey, we're less than 15 minutes away from the first Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show of the season. Tyler Merriam will be stepping in with Eric Henderson, the men's coach, and Aaron Johnston, the women's coach. 6 o'clock right here following Drive Time tonight. And if you're looking for sports on TV tonight, don't forget you got the Thursday night NFL game. Should be a good one. Arizona at Seattle, both teams are 6-3. And if you're looking for a little college football, ranked team in action tonight, 25th-ranked Tulsa, who just joined the poll, is hosting Tulane this evening.
Oh, so we got some sports going on.
Yeah.
You know what, and it's good to have some sports going on, don't you think?
Yeah.
It definitely is good to have something going on out there. On 570 WNEX, oh, my goodness, I got to tell you. There's a fella. I've always had this retirement plan.
Yeah.
I've always planned on retiring because of some freak thing that happened to me that made me wealthy.
Okay.
Right? So that's my plan to this point.
Yeah.
Is I've been going through life waiting for that freak thing to happen that's going to make me super wealthy. All right.
I
mean, it could be that I slip and fall on the sidewalk right in front of the bank.
Yeah.
I mean, but I don't know how wealthy that makes you.
Yeah.
Okay. And so then
plans?
Well, I mean, you could. I mean, there's a variety of oddball things that could happen to you.
Right.
And I don't really play the lottery, so that makes it really tough.
Yeah.
All right. But this one's out because it already happened to a fella. The very valuable space rack. This very I'm all tongue-tied. The very valuable space rock scenario.
Okay.
It's not going to happen to me. It already happened to somebody else. Josh was 33 years old. He was at home. He's at home just minding his own business. He's a coffin maker. That's what he does for a living. He makes coffins. Not in the U.S. He makes them in some other country.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a coffin maker. He's sitting at home, and all of a sudden there was a big old crash. The house just shook, and there was a big old crash. And he's like, what on earth happened here? So he called for his wife, and his wife checked things out. Joshua, stand-up, he's a lot of chivalry at their house, evidently.
Yeah.
Right? So he called for his wife. His wife went to check out what happened, and she saw a hole in the floor of their house. Then she looked up and saw a hole in the roof of their house, and whatever had gone through the floor was stuck into the ground, and it was smoking. It was too hot to pick up, so his wife dug it out with a hoe. And they took it inside. It actually went through the porch of the house.
Okay, right?
They took it inside the house. I'm assuming they let it cool down first.
Right.
But it turned out to be a space rock that had come out of the outer space, smashed through the roof of their porch into the ground right there. Now, he let the word out. He's like, hey, this rock come through. It was smoking and everything else. And so word got out that he may have had a space rock break through the roof of his porch of his house.
Uh-huh.
And then he sold some fragments of it. But there were people who wanted to buy the blasted thing. So there's an expert named Jared. He was dispatched to the home of Joshua. And he made an offer on the meteorite that came from outer space. $1.8 million. $1.8 million
Wow.
For a lump of space rock that weighed about 4.5 pounds.
Yeah. Well, that's one possibility. I don't know if you, how long you'd have to wait for the next time for that to happen.
Yeah, I don't know. You know, I've got a two-story a skylight in my apartment.
Yeah.
It'd be great because way, I mean, because I don't live in the top floor, but I could get a space rock that falls into my apartment. It would just have to come through the skylight.
Right.
Yeah, otherwise, it'd end up in someone else's apartment. And then they might get the money instead. But I think that I'm going to have to, you know, I'm gonna have to get rid of that idea. Yeah. I don't think it's probably
going
to
happen. Well, here's one. This is not going to get you $1.8 million, but Paige Nelson, mm-hmm. Chesterfield, Missouri.
Okay.
She went into a 7-Eleven and gave the clerk some money and said, give me one of those scratch-off lottery tickets.
Right.
And so he gave her one. And then she said, oh, actually what I wanted was one of those the other kind. Well, all right, I'll keep this one since you gave me this one. And so she scratched it off and won $100,000.
Really?
Yeah.
Where was she from? What's her
Chesterfield,
name?
Chesterfield, Missouri. Chesterfield. Paige Nelson. You may want to look her up.
Paige.
There,
yeah. Now, is there a picture of her?
No, there isn't.
In Paige. Mm-hmm. Is it?
Can you imagine had she given the scratch ticket back and gotten the one she really wanted and got nothing, and then the clerk would have scratched it off probably. And
yeah, could have won the bucks the there. Yeah. Is it an EN or an ON there, Steve?
ON.
That's important to know. Yeah. So, Paige.
Yeah.
I've always
you know, she's $100,000 richer.
Always thought the world of you, Paige. I'm just saying right now, you're a special kind of lady. And you give me a call someday, 1-800-367-9629. Oh, my goodness, the phone's ringing right now. It might be her. Hang on just a second. Paige, is that you? How you doing? How you doing?
Well, it ain't Paige.
It's not Paige.
But you know what? In our situation, at our age, you don't need a picture. You take any willing person, Bond.
What?
Any willing person.
Wow. Is that the tip of the day?
That is the tip of the day. Bond's the same age as I am, and he's probably better looking than I am, but no, we don't need pictures. Anyone that's willing to accept us.
I think you need T-shirts that say that. Yeah. Any willing person.
I'll take anyone that's willing to accept me, Ron. We could go as twinsies someday out on the town, Ron.
We could. The only problem is you have the perfect job. Nobody has to see you. I'm in self-cattle, and so people see me, they're like, yeah, we're staying away from him.
Yeah, well, you got to get a little bit gussied up when you go to the sale barn, Ron, that's all.
I put a different cowboy hat on for that day.
Yeah, well, you know what? You got to have, you know, here we go, Ron. Ron, since Ron has the dating tips, maybe Steve and I can help him with the, you know, with the dress
code. Do you want my dating tips? Because I haven't been on a date for 3 years.
Yeah, for 3 years, Ron. Well, you know what? It's all right. There's nothing wrong with that. Now, here's the question. Have you wanted to be on a date in those 3 years or not?
No.
Oh, well, there you go.
Yeah, see?
You see, you're getting exactly what
Ron's
you want.
Ron's too busy with what else is going on in the world. Ron, you know, is going to be the next person that has a rock fall through his house and he gets $1.8 million for it.
My problem is, though, it'd probably fall through the house and land on me and I'd be dead.
Well, you never know. Yeah. If it falls through the house,
but
Ron,
you'd have some rich relatives for that.
Yeah, that's right.
I'll let you go, but I was just going to say, we take what we can get, Bond.
There you go. But hold on just a second before you go, Ron.
All right.
Should a space rock happen to fall through your house and end up being recovered by you? I just want you to know that I've always thought a lot of you.
Yep.
Okay, Ron.
I wouldn't know you if I saw you in person.
He better put that in writing, though, to first, yeah.
Hey, thanks for the phone call, Ron. We appreciate you being part of the Drive Time Show. 570 WNEX. I'm looking at the clock here. Oh, my goodness gracious. We got to be really, 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 really fast. Super fast. I hope we can be fast enough. All right. The Korean War began in this year. North Korea invaded South Korea in June of this year. Any ideas there, Steve?
Well, it'd be like early 50s.
United States of America, this happened. The great Brinks robbery happened on the 17th of January. Brinks Armored Car Depot in Boston, Massachusetts, was burglarized by a group of 11 men. Well planned and coordinated, ended up with $2.7 million. The Diners Club issued their very first credit cards in this particular year. Any of that stuff helping you?
No, I'll go 51.
Peanuts made their debut in this year. And James Dean got his break in a TV show. A TV commercial, I should say. Steve's going to go 1951. Is it 1951? Oh, man, that was super close. Super, super close.
Yes.
You want to guess another year?
No, tell me. What am I, 1 or 2 years off?
You're only 1 year off.
Oh, okay.
1950. 570 WNAX. Coach's show right around the corner. It's the Drive Time Show. 570 WNAX.
It's time to start making plans to go with me to Washington, D.C. in early April. And not only see all the historic sites, but the beautiful cherry blossoms in the tidal basin. This is the six-day flyway to our nation's capital, and you'll see all the sites. We'll spend time visiting all the monuments, memorials, and museums. You'll stay at a hotel right next to the White House. You don't want to miss this incredible trip. See the cherry blossoms in Washington, D.C. Find details at WNAXTrips.com.
Valley Ag Supply in Gayville and Spink has a fantastic team that works around the calendar all year long to bring about the best crop outcome for their clients. Not only is their culture a strong and reliable one, but their services are strong and reliable as well. Along with their precision agronomy practices, fertilizer application, crop input, and weed control, they also have hay tarps for sale. Plus, they do hay and nitrate testing. Their goal is to always have your back. Working as a team. At Valley Ag Supply, many on the team have been with the company from the get-go. They know their clients. They know their products. And they remain committed to working with you as a farming partner. Stop by or give them a call. Valley Ag Supply in Gayville or in Spink. 605-267-3100. 605-267-3100. Valley Ag Supply.
At Iverson Ford in Huron, big end-of-the-year savings are here on the hottest Ford models. Right now, during the Built for the Holiday sales event, you can drive home a well-equipped 2020 Ford F-150 XLT. Iverson priced at $44,179. That's over $12,000 off MSRP. The same great people, the same great deals, and the same great service at Iverson Ford in Huron. Now at their new location, 2500 Dakota Avenue South, or online anytime at iversonauto.com. Not all buyers will qualify. See dealer for details. Stock number F 2761.
This is WNAX Yankton. Check out the impressive capability of the 2020 Ford F-150 at buyfordnow.com. It's 6 o'clock.
Yeah, we're good to go here. How are you? Yeah, Jaden's here, so be nice.
Hiya.
Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. This is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, brought to you by Sanford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Sanford Health. Health lives here. Case IH. Step up your game with top-performing Case IH equipment. State Farm. When you want the real deal, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, Lodge. There's a Bud Light there. First Bank and Trust, because everyone should play hard and bank easy. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card. Believe in possibility. Member FDIC. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original and your sports headquarters. Midco SN. This is how we do sports. And by Farm Credit Services of America. Call Farm Credit Services of America for your ag financing. Agriculture works here. Now, this is the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Here is your host, Tyler Merriam.
Hi, friends, and welcome to our season premiere and our season preview of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. I'm Tyler Merriam. We're not at Cubby's tonight. We are here at Frost Arena, and we'll be talking hoops for the next hour. So those of you who are with us throughout our Jackrabbit Sports Network or on GoJacks.com listening to the audio, it's great to have you alongside. Also, a new theme this year as friends on YouTube joining us also, and we've got great friends down at Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill watching this, and we remind you, you can head down to Cubby's. They're taking every precaution with everything going on with the COVID-19 pandemic. You can go down there, enjoy a great meal. You can also pick up meals to go, and a bunch of folks have turned out at Cubby's to watch the show tonight on the big screens, but we're here at Frost Arena to talk about what's to come for the SDSU men's and women's basketball teams, and it looks like we're going to have some hoops next week as we knock on wood. The men will be opening up in the Bad Boy Mowers Crossover Classic at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, scheduled to play three games on national television Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday of next week, and then the SDSU women's basketball team scheduled to be home not once but twice over the next 10 days, a week from Saturday and then a week from Monday as well. So we'll be talking about all of that over the next hour. Head women's coach Aaron Johnston will join us in just a little bit. We'll hear AJ's thoughts on the coming season. Then we'll be joined in the back half hour by the head coach of the men, Eric Henderson. As always, you have an opportunity to voice your opinion and ask your questions. We invite you to find us on Twitter. My handle is at Tyler Merriam. You can send me questions throughout the course of the show. The folks at Cubby's will be submitting some questions as well, and we'll ask all of those and a bunch others to the two head coaches of our Jackrabbit basketball programs. And some of the questions, honestly, we have more questions than answers for as far as what Frost Arena will look like for home events this coming year and everything, of course, as we've started to learn during this COVID-19 pandemic, is to be handled on a case-by-case and minute-by-minute basis. But we are excited to talk some hoops. There's a lot of optimism and excitement about both the SDSU men and SDSU women. We'll get into all that coming up. Again, we remind you that you can submit questions at Tyler Merriam is the handle on Twitter, or if you're at Cubby's, there's opportunities to submit your questions as well. We'll get to all of those and ask plenty more as the hour goes along. Thanks for joining us. If you're on radio, on YouTube, online, wherever it might be, it's great to have you with us. Great to be talking Jackrabbit Athletics once again. Stay tuned. The head coach of the SDSU women, Aaron Johnston, with us to preview the Jackrabbit women's basketball season. When we return, we are live here at Frost Arena as Cubby Sports Bar and Grill presents the season premiere of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, live on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Let's be real. You work. You worry. You wait. You wonder. These are the challenges of life on the farm. As a community bank, First Bank and Trust understands this rural reality. We're big enough to help ag producers grow for the future and small enough to get to know you right now. Our ag bankers have ag backgrounds, which means we'll help you work through the tough years and make the most of the great ones. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal opportunity lender.
Did you know that a handful of healthy soil contains more than 7 billion bugs? Some, like worms and beetles, are visible. Others, like bacteria and fungi, are microscopic. Bugs help break up soil, making space for plant roots, providing nutrients for crops, and helping soil absorb water. Learn about soil health and how it improves sustainability at thisisfarming.org. A message from South Dakota Corn.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
The wait for the holidays is over, America. It's time to make some joy. And we're here to help with the Ford Built for the Holidays sales event. We're offering the best deals of the season across the Ford lineup, so you can road trip with the whole family comfortably in a Ford Expedition. Bring home a tree that's bigger than you ever have with a built Ford Tough F-150. And find new ways to make the holidays bright this year when you visit your local Ford dealer. The joy is up to you, America, so let's get to it. Ford, Built for the Holidays.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages. Plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
When the world changes, you change.
Just under 30.
You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
Welcome back live to Frost Arena in Brookings and our season preview edition of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, your Jackrabbit headquarters located on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. Great crowd has turned out down at Cubby's. Hello to all of you, and hopefully sooner than later we can all get together like we normally do. But nevertheless, a great turnout down there. We appreciate all of your support, and we remind you that for the Jackrabbit men's and women's basketball games, whether they are here at home with limited capacity or on the road, Cubby's will have the live streams of all those you can watch on one of their 60 high-definition televisions. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, the proud presenter of our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show. Hi again, friends. Tyler Merriam, and socially distanced with us is the head women's basketball coach at South Dakota State, Aaron Johnston. We are in a much different world now than we were the last time you and I did a show like this, but tell me what this has been like for the program. How have the student-athletes handled the past few months?
Well, it's been very different. I think everyone would agree with that, no matter if you're a college athlete or just someone making your way in the world. It's been very different for all of us, so it's going to trickle into their daily lives for sure. You know, I would say this summer, I think that's where we probably were a little more unsettled, because we typically get a lot done this summer. A lot of workouts, a lot of activity, a lot of things are happening. And that was a time when everything was still so fresh and everybody was away. So we missed a lot of summer things, which is fine. Once school kind of came back, we got everybody on campus. There was a few weeks where we eased our way into things. And then after that, we've been, you know, conducting what I would consider a normal fall. So from a player perspective, I don't know that it's been a dramatic change when it comes to basketball. I think most of their changes come in other areas. I think we've talked about this before, but our players are no different than you or me, Tyler. They deal with COVID on a personal level with their families and everything going else in their worlds, just like you and I would. They have the same fears about, you know, what's it going to be like for mom or dad or sibling or, you know, and so we have those too. And we've been really sensitive, I think, to that as a staff, to make sure that you want to make it, you know, as normal as you can for basketball, but you have to remember it's not normal in any other part of their life. So to assume those things would be kind of silly on our part. So I will say, though, when they're in the gym, when they're working out, when they're practicing, it would look like the same Jackrabbit basketball team our fans are looking forward to seeing here in the next few days in Frost Arena. We haven't been limited. We haven't had a lot of issues. Our administration's been phenomenal, university and department, about creating safe places, spaces, protocols to let everybody get in the gym and pursue this dream of basketball. And I'm sure we'll talk about it, but I've been asked through email and text and calls in the last several weeks, you know, are we going to have games? Are we going to have games? Just a great reminder of the impact that Jackrabbit Athletic has on a lot of people and how much people look forward to it, because they're certainly craving that SDSU experience, and hopefully in some way, shape, or form, we'll start to see that happen in the next few weeks.
Well, you talked a little about it, and I would think for everybody, just like the fans are looking for an escape from all of this with games, for you and for the student-athletes and for your staff to get in that practice gym or to get here at Frost for a couple of hours, it's a way to get out of everything else and just go back to what you know and what is, like you said, some semblance of normalcy.
Yeah, I think so, and I think they love that, appreciate it. They're all coming from a different perspective with that. You have someone like, you know, Callie Tyson, who's trying to get back from an injury, and you know, her challenge is COVID, but it's also rehab. You have Maya Selland, whose, you know, entire season last year, majority of it was cut short. So you have people that are highly motivated for different reasons. Some, to your point, have a lot going on in their life, and getting back in the gym is a great way to use it as a release. But there is that energy. I remember we practiced in Frost Arena for the first time, because we've been mostly in the practice gym this fall. Probably about 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, something like that. And you could just see kind of the excitement, you know, in the players' eyes to be back out here. And on that particular day, I think they were doing some work, so most of the bleachers and everything were already pulled out, and it felt like you're getting ready for a game the next day. And there was that excitement in the players' eyes, and it has been fun to kind of see that. Even as a coach who's, you know, done this for a lot of years, the idea of getting back and playing is exciting for us too. So, you know, we're optimistic that we're going to be able to play games, do it safely. We know that things can change, and we're going to have to be pretty nimble and ready to adjust as needed. But right now we're moving forward with the idea of getting back to some normalcy here in Frost.
You brought up Maya Selland's name, and I've had a chance to talk to her a couple of times here over the past few months, and she wanted to, as she got healthy, also maybe redefine her physically, you know, her body a little bit, and she's done that. She said yesterday she feels as good as she has, so she's coming off an injury, yet she's going to look different physically, but by the same token, and you told me this too, she looks as good as she ever has.
Well, she's in the best shape that she's ever been in, and some of that is her drive and dedication here this off season to getting healthy. So no question that's played a role in it. Mm-hmm. But I would also say she's finally healthy enough to get in great shape. You know, there's always that issue when someone's dealing with kind of a nagging injury, you just never feel like you can get in the shape you need to be in. So, you know, fortunately she took the time off. She made a really good decision last year to do that, in part to get healthy, but in part to give herself what would feel like a normal kind of off season to train, prepare. And what I've seen from her on the floor so far this fall has been, you know, amazing. This is where, you know, we would have envisioned Maya, and where Maya would have envisioned herself when she was thinking of becoming a Jackrabbit. And for those that have seen her play and you realize, boy, she's really good, she's got a chance to be even better because she's healthy, and being healthy has allowed her to get into the kind of shape that she really wants to be in.
So Maya, of course, is the first name that comes up, but you start looking at some of those other returners you've got and the preseason All-League accolades. I mean, we don't have time to go through all of them in as much detail as we like, but you've got a number of veterans that you feel really good about.
Yeah, we've got a very good team, very experienced team in a lot of positions. Peyton Burkhart's back. She was just a foundation piece for us last year as a sophomore. A lot of basketball still in front of Peyton here in the yellow and blue, but her improvement has been outstanding. Another person that's worked really hard, in great shape. She's expanded her game, playing a little bit more on the perimeter, not as a perimeter player, but somebody that will have to be guarded on the perimeter as a post player. And in practice, she's been phenomenal for us, growing as a leader and more vocal, and you can just see it really clicking for Peyton. Tyler Irwin, who's been with us a long time and just done so many good things for our team, she's been playing a lot of different spots for us, and she will continue to do that this year, but another senior captain. We really like where Tylee's at too, and been really, really good for us. And then we got Tori back. You know, she had such a good freshman year, and again, she had to battle injuries throughout her freshman year, and she's doing good and healthy and just brings such a dynamic, you know, versatile player to our lineup. So when you look at like Peyton, and you look at Tylee, you look at Tori, Maya, you know, all those players are very multidimensional and could play almost, you know, 3-4 spots each one of them. So it gives us a lot of flexibility. And then we start sprinkling in some what we consider kind of newcomers, new faces, and that's just a really talented, good group. So we're excited where things are at right now. I feel like we're, you know, in a very normal place, and we've got a real good team.
You mentioned the four preseason All-League Award winners. Peyton Burkhart, Maya Selland on the All-Conference first team, Tylee Irwin, Torrey Nelson on the second team. We start talking about newcomers, and while you've had transfers come into your program, grad transfers are rather unique to women's basketball at SDSU. You got a good one here in Haley Greer, who comes from Colgate.
Yeah, Haley's been fantastic, and she really grew up in Illinois, so she's got some Midwestern roots. She kind of moved around as her father is also in coaching in the college and professional level, and that can be a suitcase for a lot of families, so they had to move a little bit. So she's got ties in this area. Just been a great addition, not only on the court, but she's pursuing a graduate degree here on campus and doing really well with that and enjoying it. She's a great leader, just a really good temperament for our team. It's a hard thing to be a transfer really at any time, but when you do it as a senior, and remember when she had to make that decision, we had some Zooms and we had some phone conversations, but she couldn't visit at that time because that's when COVID had shut everything down. So she had to kind of, make that decision sight unseen and really showed a lot of faith in what we believe in and really had, I think, a connection to what we want to do. And it's been great to see her excel now that she's here. So with her at the kind of point guard spot, and I know we're getting back into returners, but Lindsay Thunick has also been fantastic for us. I really like where Lindsay's at. Her and Haley give us kind of two different dimensions in that spot, but they both have played very well here so far this fall. So both of those two at the point guard position will be really good for us.
I had to laugh talking with Haley a little bit yesterday, and she said, I don't think I've ever done so many interviews in my life as I have the past few days. We just think it's business as normal, but it's not how it works every place. Mm-hmm. You mentioned Haley, three freshmen as well, and as your program over the years has shown, those freshmen aren't just there to be at the end of the bench. They're going to play and going to contribute.
Yeah, all three have done well. Emily Mesa, high school teammates, Maddie, a South Dakota name, and all three have fit in. They're very different positions. Emily's more of that kind of 2-3 position, perimeter player, really good shooter, but she's still 5'10", 5'11", so really long and athletic. Maddie's kind of that 3-4, can play that wing forward spot and really shoots the ball. Those that watched her here locally at Lenox High School can see that she's a phenomenal shooter, and she still is. Thankfully, we haven't messed that up, so she's doing a good job there. And then Mesa's more your kind of 4-5, really long, athletic center. She's really skilled. She can play on the perimeter and inside. She rebounds well, blocks shots, really mobile. So just all three of them, I think, are kind of finding their niche. But it's a big jump, and that group, along with Haley, even though she's a senior, but that group, I mean, that's hard because everything about their, senior year was turned upside down. State tournaments were lost, all of their spring activities, graduations, things that go into it. They didn't get the traditional summer here that most freshmen would get. And so their transition has been phenomenal, and they've done a great job, and despite or maybe in spite of some of their adversity, they've been positioned really well. So they're working really hard at it.
The style of play of Jackrabbit women's basketball has always adapted. At times it's been that high-low game and dominated by posts. Then you had the run there with Miller and Giebert and more perimeter dominated. You see more of a post-dominated team again here in 2020-21?
Well, yeah, we'll see. I mean, I think versatility, I think, is what we're going to have to live with. And Some days it may be that. Other days it may be some perimeter play. I think the nice thing that we have is the ability to do both. Mm-hmm. As I mentioned before, Peyton's ability to play on the perimeter really adds a lot to what we have going on. Last year she was really effective and efficient in and around the basket. But this year her versatility is important. Maya and Torrey bring that dimension. Tylee's able to do both. So we have a lot of those kind of both way in between players that can do that based on how defenses play us. But I do really like where our perimeter game is at. So far in practice, we've shot the ball really well. As I mentioned, Haley and Lindsay have been fantastic. Sydney Stapleton is a person I think people will see a lot more of this year. Played for us last year in a little more sparingly role, but I think she'll have very consistent minutes, a really good 5'10 perimeter player who can make shots, defend, really good hands, and gets in passing lanes and things, really understanding, I think, now as a junior where she can help us. So that group of perimeter players is, I don't want to say come a long way because I don't mean it that way, but I mean they've all improved and taken strides, and I mean that as a positive. So I think, we'll really have the balance to do both, even though I see a lot of forwards and strength and length inside. I still think that perimeter part will be important for what we do.
Almost everybody you have has length, which is going to cause people problems defensively, and almost everybody you have is capable of being the point guard and getting the ball up the floor. I mean, that's a nice thing to have when you can say, hey, I can play 6-7 different people at the point guard if I have to.
Yeah, I think so. I think that versatility will help. And basketball is changing now. I think it's – I don't know much about football, but I think you hear people say if you're going to play two football or two quarterbacks in football, it means you don't have one. And I'm not saying that's true or not, but I think in basketball it's different. The positions are just not so unique like they used to be. And I do think sometimes you have some real clear talents in certain positions, and they are that. But even Macy is a great player, now graduate assistant for us, was a point guard for most of her career, but as she grew, she played other spots, and that made her a better player. Maya Sellent, she'll play multiple spots for us, and that makes her a better player. So in basketball, I think that versatility is really what you see at all levels right now, and it's really a big part of what makes teams successful. But I think it's the ability to attack matchups. I think that's what we've been good at over the years, and kind of understanding what our strengths are and how to attack other teams. And this year, I think we'll have that same thought. I do think this year's team has the ability to play a little more up-tempo. We've always had good pace, but I think this year's team just has maybe that versatility and should be able to get up and down the floor and be explosive when we need to be as well, too, which I think is important for us. So, so far things have gone well, but we'll find out a lot more here in about 7-8 days. That'll be the real kind of test for us, but I'm real pleased with where we're at basketball-wise now.
We will talk about that test, the schedule, how it all came together, and much more when our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues. Presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, we are live from Frost Arena on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Let's be real. You want views. You love windows. You need space. You hate commuting. We understand the wishes you have for your new home. That's why First Bank and Trust is here with local mortgage lenders to make your loan process easier. We work hard to keep things on track so you close on time. Plus, we're big enough to offer competitive rates. We're also small enough to know your neighborhood. Hey, we might even know your neighbors. First Bank and Trust. Real banking. Real easy. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Did you know that a handful of healthy soil contains more than 7 billion bugs? Some, like worms and beetles, are visible. Others, like bacteria and fungi, are microscopic. Bugs help break up soil, making space for plant roots, providing nutrients for crops, and helping soil absorb water. Learn about soil health and how it improves sustainability at thisisfarming.org. A message from South Dakota Corn.
The wait for the holidays is over, America. It's time to make some joy. And we're here to help with the Ford Built for the Holidays sales event. We're offering the best deals of the season across the Ford lineup, so you can road trip with the whole family comfortably in a Ford Expedition. Bring home a tree that's bigger than you ever have with a built Ford Tough F-150. And find new ways to make the holidays bright this year when you visit your local Ford dealer. The joy is up to you, America, so let's get to it. Ford, Built for the Holidays.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Directors' Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Directors' Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Need a win? Visit Royal River in Plandreau. Take the crown during the Royal Winnings Giveaway and win your share of $71,000 cash. Every Friday and Saturday from 5 to 10 p.m., win up to $1,000 nightly. Plus, earn entries daily into the drawing on December 31st, where one guest wins $21,000. Then enjoy our Sweet Dreams Giveaway every Wednesday from 8 to 8. Earn 100 points on your Royal Rewards card and get your piece of a betting set. And one lucky guest will win a $2,000 Montgomery's gift card on October 28th at 8:15 p.m. Limited quantities. Royal River Casino, must be 21.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Welcome back to Frost Arena and more of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, our season preview edition, which is presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. You can book a holiday party now at Cubby's. Limited availability. Of course, COVID-19 regulations will apply. 696-7978 to reserve your space. Again, the Cubby's phone number is 605-696-7978. You can go there for a meal in person. You can pick it up to go. It is certainly a favorite in my household. I'm sure it is in AJ's, and it should be in yours if it isn't. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings, your Jackrabbit game day headquarters. I'm Tyler Merriam, the head coach of the SDSU women's basketball team. Aaron Johnston is with us here in Frost Arena. It is an empty Frost Arena, which we are used to in situations like this. We're not used to it in basketball games, and we still don't know for sure exactly what Frost is going to look like from a fan standpoint, but we know it's going to be different. Road games are going to be different. So is that something that you and the team, have you guys talked about that? Is it just one of those things everybody knows? How are you handling that? Because, again, we know how much a crowd can impact a basketball game.
Yeah, and lack of crowd can too. You know, it's certainly the noise makes a big difference, and our fans over the years have been phenomenal. But I'm sure we'll play in some arenas this year that are basically empty. Yeah. And we've done that a few times on the road without a pandemic, to be honest with you. So we are kind of aware of it. But I know some of the opponents that we're going to play are going to be, you know, 50% capacity, and their arenas are big enough where they'll have their typical women's crowd, I guess is my point. And so when you're talking about those percentages capacity, it may not change some people's crowd. You're still going to have some. And there are a couple of our non-conference opponents right now that aren't allowing any fans that we know of. Now, some of that could change, so we'll see. So we've kind of talked about that just so they understand it. And as we get closer to each game, we'll try and get our arms around what their, you know, what their plan is, so we can be as prepared as possible. But it'll be different, both with fans in some places and then just empty in others. Because basketball is, as all sports in many ways, but basketball is certainly an energy, momentum kind of game. And you can either be hurt because of the fan base or feed off of a fan base, and that whole dynamic is gone. So we've got to energize ourselves and find ways to be, you know, really fired up and go. But I just think the chance to play, certainly here in Frost Arena, is going to be enough for us here in these first couple of games to get going, I think, and be motivated and be ready to enjoy it.
You guys had a schedule put together that was going to be one of the better ones you've had, which is impressive to say because you've had some really good ones in the non-conference. Then this all happens. Does everything get ripped up? Did you start from scratch? Did you have a few holdovers? How does it go from what you had originally to what you have now and what we announced a couple of days ago?
Yeah, well, we did have a good schedule, as you mentioned. Megan Lewick does our scheduling right now, our assistant coach. And, you know, when this came up, really 2 months ago, everything just kind of, I would say, a little bit fell apart and was uncertain. Yeah. As soon as they announced we were going to have games, they also announced the start date was pushed back 2 weeks and we're going to lose four games. So right away, you know, you have to kind of reach out to everybody. And Megan did all of this. So everything you'll see here, she deserves the credit for. But just had to connect with people, see who was still on, who wasn't. And it's been a mixed bag. Some people we talked to are like, yeah, of course, we're coming. We're going to play the game. Nothing's going to change. Some people are like, ooh, we're going to have to wait and see. We've got this, this, and this. And then some of those people flip sides of that equation. You know, some stayed. So it was like daily interaction with all of the schools. I think we ended up losing probably four, maybe, not just the NCAA games, but four teams that we were going to play that we are not going to play this year or potentially are pushing those back. We picked up some new faces, which has actually been good. I mentioned this to many people, but I think some of our not luck, but some of our ability to get some of those people, I think, was represented. And they're thinking, well, if we can, you know, go to Frost Arena and they may not have their normal fan base, this is the year to go. So yeah. We did have some teams that I think we were able to get a two-year agreement with that hadn't done that in the past. Iowa State's a good example of that. It'd be the first time we play them in a regular season game here. And I think geography and a lot of things played a role in that. So we're really glad that that worked out. They're a top 25 team, very good, always really well coached, a lot of great players, some familiar faces to our players see in the summer, you know, in all those kind of circuits. We get Gonzaga to come back. That was, you know, something we've done years ago, but we're excited to have that game again. Missouri State's a new opponent for us, never played them again. But then I would say some other kind of existing ones worked out. We'll have Creighton, we'll have Drake, we'll have you and I. So this will be a tough schedule, that is for sure. A few teams that are ranked, a few others that are just outside of those rankings. But we're really fortunate. And we didn't have to give up a lot. Well, to have five home games is phenomenal. I know we'll see kind of what that means for fans, but just to not have to put our team on the road right now with all the uncertainty of travel and everything that goes into it. The two, you know, I call them road trips. We play four games on the road. They're both kind of, you know, two trips, are fairly manageable for us. So it worked out about as well as we could have. People won't believe me, but we know people in our, you know, profession, women's program, some of them have maybe two or three non-conference games scheduled as of today. So we're in a really good place. And we know things can change. We know we're always kind of day-to-day testing will tell us what we can do and can't do. But to have this as the possibility was really good. And Megan, Matt Maher, Associate Athletic Director, works really extensively with all of our contracts. And that was a hard process, really hard process. And those two put a lot into it and pulled off a great schedule.
The contracts are unbelievable to try to put together, and thankfully Matt Maher has a background in law, which gives us a one-up on a lot of senior associate athletic directors around the country. But that work, and then the work from a facility and operations standpoint, not only to get you on the floor to practice and to get you in the weight room and to get you with athletic training and some of those things, but to find a way to play home games in whatever environment that's going to be, whether it's a couple hundred people or you get a bigger number than that, and we might not know that again to a day-by-day basis, I mean, based upon where everything's at and working with folks across campus. But Jeff Holm, Christy Williams, Rachel Anello, everybody on that side of it, you mentioned Matt and so many others. I mean, this is a truly tremendous group that had to all come together to give you this opportunity.
Yeah, definitely, you know, a team. That's really what they've done. And they've all had, you know, unique specialties, and that's been great. Our sports medicine people have a whole different, you know, plan that they have to do just to get people to come in the building. Strength conditioning, you know, you have a traditional plan of how people are going to lift, and now they have to do that differently. You mentioned the facility side of it. So, yeah, it's been a big undertaking. And it's an undertaking a lot of places have said, hey, we're not going to do. We're just going to not play games, or you're going to go on the road, and, you know, doors have been closed. So, I can't tell you how much we appreciate everybody at South Dakota State, the people you mentioned, and President Dunn and his team that have worked very closely, I know, with our department to make all these things possible. You know, they've really done a phenomenal job of creating a student experience, which is also a student-athlete experience for all of the young people here on campus to feel involved, engaged, pursue their dreams. Some of those are academic, some of those are athletic, and it's really been the best of a very difficult situation so far.
One thing before I let you go, we have announced over the past couple of weeks the 8 new inductees into the Jackrabbit Sports Hall of Fame. The 8th one will be announced tomorrow. The first 7 are already out, and 2 of them have ties to women's basketball. One of them, Chris Nelson, who played every sport in the 1970s, just a much different era. And her recruiting story, if you go on GoJacks.com, is something else, and I use recruiting very liberally. But then Shannon Schlegel, of course, who played for you and was a huge part, not only in the Division II National Championship team, but made the game-winning basket in the first Division I win when you guys beat Kentucky.
Yeah, you know, starting off with Chris, I've gotten to know her just through her connection to SDSU and all the time she's come back to alumni events, and still really engaged with what's going on here in Brookings. She is a Jackrabbit and always will be. It is interesting to hear the stories of what the world was like for her as a student athlete at that time, and very different than what we experience right now. But she's just as appreciative of, you know, her experience that I think someone like Shannon was, we'll kind of transition to, who's also going in the Hall of Fame. So two different stories, but two very meaningful and powerful stories that have had huge impact on SDSU, and I'd be willing to say SDSU, they'd agree, had that impact on them. Shannon, you know, we just owe a heck of a lot to her. She was national champion, you know, one of the very best to ever play here, helped us be successful in Division One, and there were other people on those teams too, obviously. She was the best player on the floor most of the time when we had Division II games, and she was the best player on the floor most of the time when we had Division I games. And a lot of people don't quite acknowledge that, but she was. And she was a tremendous talent, and a lot has gone into a lot of years, but women's basketball is in a much better place now for, you know, what she brought to the table at that time.
AJ, it's great to see you healthy. Certainly wish nothing but the best to you and the family and your squad, and looking forward to seeing some women's basketball here at Frost Arena in 9 days.
We'll see you then. Thanks.
AJ, thank you. Aaron Johnston, head women's basketball coach. When we come back to Frost Arena, the men's coach, Eric Henderson, joins us on our season premiere of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, live inside Frost Arena, presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters, with more than 50 TVs providing the area's best sports viewing environment, including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages, plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings, and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Let's be real. When it's time to start adulting, teens need a bank account, like a Real Deal bank account, one that's free and offers some perks. Check out Real Deal Checking from First Bank and Trust. It's free checking with ATM fee refunds, a free custom image debit card, and cash rewards when you qualify. You get free mobile banking with all its cool capabilities, and seriously, your personal finance teacher would be so impressed. Real Deal Checking by First Bank and Trust. Real banking, real easy. For full details, visit bankeasy.com or stop in today.
Member FDIC.
The wait for the holidays is over, America. It's time to make some joy. And we're here to help with the Ford Built for the Holidays sales event. We're offering the best deals of the season across the Ford lineup, so you can road trip with the whole family comfortably in a Ford Expedition. Bring home a tree that's bigger than you ever have with a built Ford Tough F-150. And find new ways to make the holidays bright this year when you visit your local Ford dealer. The joy is up to you, America, so let's get to it. Ford, built for the holidays.
Did you know that a handful of healthy soil contains more than 7 billion bugs? Some, like worms and beetles, are visible. Others, like bacteria and fungi, are microscopic. Bugs help break up soil, making space for plant roots, providing nutrients for crops, and helping soil absorb water. Learn about soil health and how it improves sustainability at thisisfarming.org. A message from South Dakota Corn.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
30 seconds.
Okay.
When the world changes, you change with it. You push through uncertainty by embracing new rhythms and redefining connection. At Sanford Health, we're standing with you at every point along the way, committed to delivering the care you need when you need it. Because even when your world looks different, you can be confident we've taken every step to keep you safe while you're in our care. Call your local clinic or visit sanfordhealth.org to make an appointment.
Hi, friends, and welcome back. We are live inside Cubby's. We're live inside Frost Arena. I knew I was going to do that once. I knew it, Hendo. We're live here at Frost Arena with the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, our season preview edition presented by Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill. Normally, we would be live at Cubby's with a great group of Jackrabbit fans. Many of them have turned out at Cubby's. Thank you to all of you who are watching at Cubby's, or if you're watching throughout the world via YouTube, or if you're listening throughout our flagship 570 WNAX and the Jackrabbit Sports Network. We remind you, Cubby's has taken every precaution. There is no need to be worried if you're looking for a nice meal, be it yourself or with your family. Head on down to Cubby's, and you can also get great takeout. Cubby's Sports Bar and Grill, Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. I'm Tyler Merriam, not at Cubby's. We are here at Frost Arena with the head men's basketball coach at South Dakota State, Eric Henderson. We heard from AJ a little while ago, and now here we are socially distanced having this conversation. Much different world we live in nowadays, my friend, but it is good to see you and good to be talking some hoops.
Oh, it's always good to be talking hoops, Tyler, and it is. You're right, it is. I'm fortunate that we're not down at Cubby's. Great establishment, and I know my family grabs some takeout there once
Absolutely.
In a while, so life is good. But we are excited for the season, there's no doubt.
Well, this has been such just a whirlwind of things that have happened, and I want to go back because it's so interesting how one game or one moment can, I don't know if tarnish is the right word, but just change the outlook on everything, because you look back to going into the last week of the regular season last year, and we're sitting here going, you've already clinched at least a share of a Summit League regular season title. You're going to be a one or a two seed in the tournament. You got a chance for an outright league crown. Coming off losing Mike Dom and losing David Jenkins Jr. and TJ Otzelberger leaves. And there were so many questions. And here you are, you've won 20-plus games. It's a great season by all accounts. And then because the last two games go 2 points in the wrong direction, it's almost like it ended with a thud, and it's a disappointment, and it's anything but you just have that aftertaste that just it's just not fun.
Yeah, there's still a knot in our stomach.
Yeah.
I can tell you that much. It was a bittersweet, because when you look back and reflect on the year, and I'm so proud of our guys and the new guys and our staff for being able to, you know, come together and really, you know, putting a good product on the floor, and our guys, you know, compete like crazy and really share the basketball. And then it left a, you know, a bitter taste in our mouth at the end of the year, the way it ended. We were playing, you know, the way we wanted to play. We had some good identity and you know, and then when Douglas got hurt, it was just a, you know, we were deflated a little bit. We go up to, you know, Fargo and a heck of a game and lose in overtime to North Dakota State without Doug. And you know, it didn't feel good, you know. And so then going into the Summit League tournament, you know, it was just, you took a lot of new guys there, a lot of fresh guys that hadn't had that experience, you know, in that environment. But, you know, as bitter as, you know, taste in our mouth we used it as motivation. And our guys are hungry and they're excited. It was a unique summer. It was, you know, obviously a lot of uncertainty, and there's still a lot of uncertainty. But our guys got after it, and they worked, and we're excited to get the ball tipped and ready to roll.
The characterization of your basketball team, I think, is best summed up like this, in that you've got five starters back from last year, what you consider a veteran team, and yet I had an email today from one member of the Summit League Media Relations staff, Ryan Powell, who leads it up, and he said, hey, can you tell me how close guys are to 1,000 points? I'm putting together a list, who's 800 and above? And I said, nobody's over 700 for SDSU. So here you got all these starters back, yet nobody's near 1,000 points yet because you're so young yet so experienced. That's a very unique combination.
Yeah, it really is, and you know, as bitter it was of how it ended, there's a lot of excitement because of what we have coming back, and you know, how we played together and really unselfish, and that's what I was most proud of last year, you know, and our guys have taken those same characteristics and we're trying to build on them, and you know, so we have some more experience, but they're still pretty raw, they're still pretty fresh, and we're still learning.
Douglas Wilson, I know he's been practicing. I know he's jacked up and ready to go. How's he feeling? How's he looked in workouts?
He's done a tremendous job with his body. I know our fans are going to notice a big difference. His shoulders are a lot bigger than mine, my friend. But he's really explosive. He's, you know, I hold him out every once in a while just because I want to keep him fresh. It's a long season, but he's ready to go. He's itching, you know, to get back out on the court there against other team against somebody else other than his teammates, you know. They're tired of getting at each other's throats. So it's time to, you know, play somebody else, and he's certainly ready to go and excited.
If it was any other team, Noah Friedel would be the story. The look at this guy, what he did in the Summit League tournament in that game against Fort Wayne with 36, and how he ended the year, had a tremendous stretch run. And yet everybody wants to talk about Wilson, it seems like, and they forget – You might have the two best players in the league right now, at least with how the season ended, and being a South Dakota kid, there's a lot of spotlight on Noah Friedel.
Yeah, I'm really proud of Noah. You know, it's been a learning curve for him. You know, we've had some bumps in the road and some teaching moments where we've had to talk about and learn from, and that's what makes me so proud of him, because he hasn't taken the poor me attitude or anything like that. Every single moment, every mistake per se that he's made, we've kind of taken it and said, how are we going to get better from that? And that's the sign of maturity. That's the sign of growth. You don't expect your kids to be perfect, but you want them to be. But when they're not, you expect them to learn from the mistakes. And that's what I'm most proud of Noah. He's come to practice with a much better approach, a great energy. And, he wants to, evolve his game as well, expand his game, get to the basket more. And he put a ton of time in that this summer when we weren't able to compete against each other. You know, we used it for skill development and tried to get our guys to get better at some of their weaknesses and improve on some of their strengths. And Noah's no exception.
I had somebody in the league media call me and say, as they were putting together their preseason ballot, I might have to put three Jacks at the top, put them 1, 2, and 3. And I bring this up because with Matt Dentlinger, he doesn't have the flashiness of Douglas Wilson. He doesn't shoot the three like Noah Friedel. Yet there were games last year he was the best player on the floor, and that's pretty darn impressive to say.
You know what you're going to get. You know, Matt's an everyday guy that is Mr. Consistent. He plays both ends of the floor. He impacts it in great ways on both sides of the basketball. And so he's an unbelievable student, unbelievable character kid, and just one of the leaders of our team that, you know, like you said, makes a huge impact on the floor.
We've talked about the three preseason All-League honorees that are returners. We invite you to stay tuned. We're going to talk about some of the newcomers, some of those other guys we haven't gotten to in the returners, the Shiremans, the Arians, etc. We'll do all of that. Talk about the schedule as well, coming up with the head coach of the SDSU men, Eric Henderson, when our Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show continues. Presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, we're live inside Frost Arena on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College.
Cubby Sports Bar and Grill is your sports headquarters with more than 50 TVs providing the area's
4-minute break and then I'll call it 57,
including the NFL Sunday Ticket, ESPN College Extra, NHL Center Ice, and other sports packages.
Yes.
Plus daily food and drink specials, open to all ages daily at 11 and Saturdays at 10. Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, a Brookings original in downtown Brookings and a proud sponsor of the Jacks.
Did you know that a handful of healthy soil contains more than 7 billion bugs? Some, like worms and beetles, are visible. Others, like bacteria and fungi, are microscopic. Bugs help break up soil, making space for plant roots, providing nutrients for crops, and helping soil absorb water. Learn about soil health and how it improves sustainability at thisisfarming.org. A message from South Dakota Corn.
The wait for the holidays is over, America. It's time to make some joy. And we're here to help with the Ford Built for the Holidays sales event. We're offering the best deals of the season across the Ford lineup, so you can road trip with the whole family comfortably in a Ford Expedition. Bring home a tree that's bigger than you ever have with a built Ford Tough F-150. And find new ways to make the holidays bright this year when you visit your local Ford dealer. The joy is up to you, America, so let's get to it. Ford, Built for the Holidays.
It's back, the return of the prestigious Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, honoring college sports excellence across all competitive divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow along with L Director's Cup on Twitter or online to see which schools will be taking home a first-place trophy in June for their season-long success. Learfield IMG College Director's Cup, a premier institutional award jointly launched in 1993 by USA Today and NACTA.
Let's be real. You work, you worry, you wait, you wonder. These are the challenges of life on the farm. As a community bank, First Bank and Trust understands this rural reality. We're big enough to help ag producers grow for the future and small enough to get to know you right now. Our ag bankers have ag backgrounds, which means we'll help you work through the tough years and make the most of the great ones. First Bank and Trust,
minute
real
30.
Banking, real easy. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
Whether you're buying or selling your home, turn to the dedicated team of professionals at Century 21, Krogman & Company. Century 21 is a proud member of Jack's Home Team and is the preferred real estate partner of Jackrabbit Athletics. Check them out today at century21brookings.com. Or for more information on Jack's Home Team, visit gojacks.com/home team.
Need a win? Visit Royal River in Plainview. Take the crown during the Royal Winnings Giveaway and win your share of $71,000 cash. Every Friday and Saturday from 5 to 10 p.m., win up to $1,000 nightly. Plus, earn entries daily into the drawing on December 31st, where one guest wins $21,000. Then enjoy our Sweet Dreams Giveaway every Wednesday from 8 to 8. Earn 100 points on your Royal Rewards card and get your piece of a betting set. And one lucky guest will win a $2,000 Montgomery's gift card on October 28th at 8:15 p.m. Limited quantities. Royal River Casino, must be 21.
What's different about LG Seeds? You get a team of real people focused on real results for your entire operation. While other companies say teamwork, LG Seeds lives it. From lab to field, we're there every step of the way to help you find your next advantage. Pair that with your drive, and it all comes down to this. Divide the tasks, multiply the results. Get down to business at lgseeds.com.
Welcome back to our season premiere edition of the Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show, presented by Cubby Sports Bar and Grill, your Jackrabbit Game Day headquarters on Main Avenue here in downtown Brookings. And remember, as we look ahead to next week, we're scheduled to have 5 basketball games in the span of 6 days, 3 in Sioux Falls, 2 here in Brookings between the men and the women. All of those games will be available at Cubby's, and you can go and watch them and enjoy all of their award-winning wings, sandwiches, burgers, wraps, etc. Cubby's on Main Avenue in downtown Brookings. That brings me, Eric Henderson, the head men's coach, to a question that was submitted from our friends at Cubby's. What does Hendo prefer at Cubby's? And there is an A, B, or C for this. Is it the Chislic, the nachos, or a burger?
It's D, that cheesesteak sandwich, brother.
I'll go
every
to
day. Every day, that thing is ridiculously good.
I thought you were going to say D, all of the above.
I go the cheesesteak almost every time.
The cheesesteak is the go-to.
There's a salad that's pretty good there, too.
The buffalo chicken salad
is
excellent.
Very good.
I mean, we've talked about I'm a buffalo chicken guy, and Jeremy and Gus and the boys know how to stole it. They know how to do that. So we talked about the three preseason all-league honorees. But you've got Baylor Shireman back. You've got Alex Arians back. You've got Matt Mims back. Trey Buchanan, who didn't really get a chance to show off as much as he could have because he got hurt during the non-conference and missed all of conference play. I mean, again, on top of those other three, this is a core coming back you got to feel really good about.
Yeah, there's no doubt. You talked about the three guys that got all conference awards, but the other guys are equally as important, you know, and you can throw David Winget in that mix. And,
absolutely.
And, you know, it was unfortunate what Trey had to go through last year, but, you know, we're going to need all those guys. It's going to be a weird year. There's going to be guys that miss games, and that is what it is. And everybody's got to be ready for their moment. And, you know, it was really enjoyable to look back on last year when, you know, silly coach, I don't even play Matt Mims the first 12 games, and then all of a sudden, you know, it's hard to keep him off the floor at the end of the year because of the energy he brings, making shots and different things. So, everybody's got to be ready for their moment, and whether it's Trey getting healthy and taking advantage of those opportunities, David, expanding his game, Baylor the same way, and Mimsy, and then, a couple new guys as well.
Speaking of those new guys, you got one who was here for the second semester last year in Willie Mfum is how you say his name, the Columbus, Ohio native. And then on top of that, you've got Cooper Cornerman, you've got Luke Apple, and you've got Charlie Easley, a transfer from Nebraska. Apple's a JUCO transfer. So you've got some fresh blood in here, which I know are making those guys work hard because those guys coming in don't know that they're supposed to sit on the bench. They think they're coming in to play right away.
That's for sure. They all do, my friend. we're excited about those new guys. You know, Willie, you know, spent the last semester with us last year and was able to start to get more comfortable within our system and things. But, and he's still developing and he needs more reps and he needs, time to play 5-on-5, an opportunity to make mistakes and learn from them mistakes and grow. And then, Charlie, easily coming from Nebraska, he you know, he started four Big Ten games for him last year, so he's got some experience at a high level. You know, I think, you know, he came here and, you know, you think when you come down, you come to South Dakota State from a Nebraska, you feel like maybe you'd be one of the better players, and you, the impact that you can have is really, really large. And he's like, you know, he comes in and he'll say to me, he goes, "Japers, you guys have great players, you know." And it's a little harder than I thought, maybe. So it's fun to see that. And but Charlie's a competitor now; he's a fighter. And our fans are going to like watching him play along with Luke Apple, you know, very, very talented offensive player, still learning, you know, defensively the impact that he can have and the energy that he has to play with and the purpose he has to play with on an every single possession deal. You know, he shows signs, and he just needs to get more consistent, and those, that comes with experience. It comes with opportunity. So it'll be fun to watch his progress throughout the year as well. And then Scoop's done a good job. You know, the cornerman kid, you know, he does a good job in practice and battling and understanding what we're trying to get accomplished, and he's a great part of the team as well.
How hard was it putting together a non-conference schedule?
It's always challenging. Take it to a whole nother level, brother. I'll tell you, it's just so much uncertainty. And as we talked about before, you know, we were all geared up to play Creighton that first game. And, you know, about 2 hours ago, they decide, you know, they have some cases pop up and they have to withdraw from the Bad Boy Classic. So there's still uncertainty out there. And we're going to take every moment that we have and control what we can control, Tyler. You know, whoever's put in front of us will be ready to go.
The Bad Boy Morris Crossover Classic is scheduled for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday of next week. And as far as you know, the plan is still to move forward and to have that event even with Creighton dropping out.
They got great leadership there. You know, Samford puts on unbelievable events. Everybody recognizes that across the country, you know. So we're still really super confident that that thing's going to take place. And they'll find a team to replace Creighton. And then, you know, like I said, this is a year if you can deal with adversity and punches from the left and punches from the right a little better than your opponents, I feel like you have a great chance. And we have a resilient group, and we're not going to worry about things we can't control. We're going to worry about ourselves, and whoever's in front of us, we're going to be ready to play that day and let the outcome determine itself.
How excited are you to go back to Ames, Iowa and play at Iowa State?
Yeah, it's exciting. I know, you know, obviously Coach Peterson on our staff played there. I was a GA.
Is his jersey being retired when we go back there? Is that what I hear?
It
should be if it isn't.
Usually guys that, you know, score about 4 points a game don't make that happen, you know. Just kidding. But obviously it'll be really special for him. It's going to be special for me as well. You know, it's a great environment, even though, you know, they're not going to have as many fans as they usually do. But, you know, to play a high major school like that that's close to us, that, you know, there's some history. They understand what South Dakota State basketball is all about. And they understand they're going to be in for a dogfight, too.
Yeah, Bradley as well in the three games of the Samford Pentagon and the South Dakota Classic. Coach, our time is up, unfortunately. Great to see you, and looking forward to talking hoops with you and seeing the team play next week.
Appreciate it, Tyler. And I can't wait to get back down to Cubbies and see all our great fans.
It's going to be a lot of fun. For
yes.
Eric Henderson, for Aaron Johnston, I'm Tyler Merriam. Thanks for joining us here from Frost Arena. Thanks to all of you who showed up at Cubby Sports Bar and Grill. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, the men next week. Saturday and Monday, the women. Basketball is almost here. Thanks for joining us on the Jackrabbit Sports Network from Learfield IMG College.
Learfield IMG College. The Jackrabbit Basketball Coaches Show has been brought to you by Samford Health. Even in uncertain times, we're ready to see you. Samford Health. Health lives here. Bud Light. Whenever there's a game to watch, there's a Bud Light there. Case
thank
IH.
You.
Step up your game with top performing Case IH.